Good afternoon. I'm Bill O'Neill in Raleigh. What a debate on this issue here today. The Republicans came up short in the end by the vote. They were trying to override the governor on the issue of the live abortion bill. The House had already passed it. The Senate had already passed it. The Senate overrode the governor's veto. But the House did not. Tried it again today. It failed. And I can tell you, throughout this day, Republicans put on a full court pressure over this issue.
I don't die easy. Thank you, Jesus.
Two abortion survivors make pleas to North Carolina lawmakers shortly before today's vote and issue a warning to them.
We all will answer to God one day. And so I want to ask North Carolina to do what's right, to do the right thing, to do the good thing.
Isn't anybody upset over the fact that we're even having this debate?
Senate Bill 359 requires doctors to provide medical treatment to babies born after a botched abortion. But Democrats say the bill is unnecessary.
Well, I feel like there are some very harsh penalties that are imposed on doctors. And I think that's the issue, getting in the way of a doctor's judgment. And I just think we make lousy doctors.
If you look at what's really going across the country, there's a war on women's ability to make their own health care choices. And I think that's unfortunate.
PolitiFact reports that U.S. laws already protect infants born during abortions. Verified reports of doctors killing those infants are rare. And North Carolina doesn't track that specific occurrence.
Because there's no reporting requirement, we don't know. We don't know how often it happens. And this makes sure that there'll be reportings, and it makes it ironclad clear that if this baby is born, this baby has to be taken care of.
Republicans needed seven Democrats to cross over today. They came up short on that vote. The final vote was 67-53. That is short of the 60% that is required. One interesting point here. If now one of the Republicans voted with the Democrats, it opens the door to keep this issue alive. It is not clear whether or not that happened here today. In Raleigh, I'm Bill O'Neill, WXII 12 News.
Bill, thank you very much. Let's get